So is this intro getting you psyched up for an amazing adventure? Good, because that intro is never made reference to ever again. This is Hoshiwo Mirohito, otherwise known as Stargazers for the Famicom. It is easily the worst RPG ever created. There is no reason anyone should ever have to suffer through this load of balls. Which is precisely why I'm going to play it. Oh yes, as stated in the intro, there is no complete playthrough of this game on YouTube. So, I saw fit to do it myself. Aren't I a nice guy, suffering just for the greater good? Oh yeah, and breathe in this majestic intro as well, because this is probably the best thing about this game. That little picture of space or whatever right there. The fairly epic music, as a matter of fact. I actually like some of the music from this game. Music is not good enough to outweigh the poorly designed, like, crap that the rest of the game has in store for you. Oh yes, you thought any given... Well, let's see here. Take the Final Fantasy game that you hate the most, this game is worse. I mean, look at how slow you walk. That's just sad. Oh, and, a word about the random encounters. They are, in fact, random. Because... Well, this is the beginning of the game, and, oh yeah, notice that my... You can't see this, the ones digit in my HP, just in case you were thinking, oh, he's only got 5 HP, he's gonna die. I'm still gonna die, because even though this is the beginning of the game, this is the first enemy I've run into. He's still gonna kill me, and it seems like I should be dead right now, but I'm not. And now I'm dead. Like, ouch. See, that's the problem with this game. The random encounters are so poorly balanced, it's not even funny. So, this is how the game saves. It uses a password system. And you're probably thinking, password saves? In an RPG? How bad could that possibly be? Well, first let me point out that the game uses both English letters and Japanese letters, and numbers, and the copyright symbol. I mean, holy shit, that's just... If you're writing this down, you're gonna be in for one hell of a time. Especially if you're not used to writing Japanese letters, because let me tell you, trying to write those down is beyond crazy. And the password is 35 letters long. Oh yes! Let's see, I can think of plenty of games with absurdly long passwords, such as Castlevania 2, Rambo for the NES, Who Framed Roger Rabbit for the NES. Those pale in comparison to this. I mean, really? 35 letters long! Couldn't they have just made a save system? Like, it can't be that hard to make a save system on the Famicom. Well, actually, this is just the, this is the original Japanese version I've been showing you up until now. I have an English translation. There exists an English translation. The English translation adds the ability to save without passwords. I mean, think about that! The English translation also speeds up the walking speed, which I am very thankful for. So yeah, now I'm just dicking around. I spelled fuck this because fuck this! I'm not gonna use passwords. Even though the English translation lets you use regular save files, I'm still gonna use save states. This is emulated, of course. Okay, here's the English translation. Obviously, it says Stargazers up there at the top. Not sure if it should be plural or not, but let's start the game. Now I can walk faster, and actually, I should have mentioned this before, I am actually going to cheat my way through this game, because, honestly, let me just point out two things. first of all, there are no bosses in the game. Like, ever. There are no bosses. So, as you can see, I've hacked my way to level 30, because, honestly, who would ever waste their time grinding in a terrible game like this? And I could have sworn I had more gold than that, but... And since I've hacked my way to level 30, I've given myself all the ESP abilities, including Bad Teleport, which allows you to instantly eliminate an enemy from the battle. Only thing is, you don't get any gold if you use that method. But I don't care. I can hack myself 3,000 gold whenever I want to. And since I'm level 30, I have the ability to pass through walls, like you just saw. You can pass through walls if the wall is 4 tiles or less in length. You need this. I was considering cutting out all the random encounters, but... even at level 30, my bare fists are doing no damage. Yeah. I think I'll cut out the random encounters in the future. There's really nothing interesting about the random encounters. As stated, there are no bosses. Okay, so this area I am in, each of those forest tiles will randomly send you to this place, which I presume to be a hole in the ground. The graphics are terrible, so it's really hard to, tell. So anyways, those forest tiles randomly send you to this area. You need to come here at least once, but, anyways, here's what you're here for. Yeah, the gimmick to this game is that you can collect fruit and turn them into potions. It's not a terrible idea, but yeah, I exit that place and somehow I wind up back where I started the game. It doesn't make any sense. Like, but that's actually a neat little shortcut, because now, here's the first town. Which, coincidentally, didn't look anything like a town on the map. Now, did it? And he just told me the recipe for the potion I need to cure this, town of its everlasting disease. Yeah. I don't know how I'm not affected by this town's disease, but, you know, we need to cure these good people of their disease by getting all of the potion ingredients, making the potion, and bringing it back here. If they know how to make the potion, why don't they just do it themselves? Well, anyways, there's fruit number 2. Ingredient number 2, whatever. I exit this town, and I wind up back at the start again. So you're probably wondering where I should go now. Well, the real first town was invisible on the map. Go figure. Why would you make the first town invisible? Do you know how easy it is to miss that? Like, if I were actually playing as for real, like, if I were to grind all the way to level 30, go figure. Like, I'd ever do that. By the way, here's the weapon shop. Don't buy the ray gun because it's worse than your bare hands. Seriously. The first weapon of... The cheapest weapon in the game is worse than your bare hands. Now, I thought for sure I had enough money to buy the rag launcher. That's another thing. Rag launcher? Seriously? So, like, already I've pointed out 4 or 5 different things that make you go, what the hell? So now I just need to get my potion. Costs 15 gold, go figure. Make sure you select the ingredients in the right order, too, or you'll lose them, and you have to collect them all over again. At least that's what I think happens. Item 6. Well, I guess the translation's not finished yet. Actually, it isn't. This translation is only about 80% done, but I doubt the translator wants to bother finish translating a piece of shit like this game. And why would he? Why would anyone? 3 enemies. This is gonna take a while. I just love that jumping sound effect. So here's the diseased town. I've got the item I need, I assume. So now what? Do I just save the town automatically? An ID card. Good to know that I need an ID card. Thank you. So I saved the town. So just by bringing the item into the town, I've automatically saved the town? Like, really? That's retarded! He still tells me what the ingredients for the potion are. Okay, apparently I have saved their lives, so seems like a good place as any to stop for now. Let me tell you, this game gets worse and worse, believe me.